Hello everyone, welcome to K-Pop Queen for your daily reactions to all things K-Pop. Right now I'm about to do finally the reaction to Red Velvet's The Velvet second mini album. Okay, I'm actually really excited for this because if you guys have seen my other reaction to Red Velvet's album, The Red, which was their first album, you guys will know how I suddenly became a huge Red Velvet fan because it was a serious jam album. Like, I could go on forever about how great those songs are. Just watch that video if you want to know what I'm talking about. But yeah, I'm gonna do the reaction for The Velvet, the second mini album, and this one is gonna be obviously just more R&B, very, I think more, I wouldn't say necessarily slow, but I will say this maybe not as necessarily upbeat as the first album was, The Red. So the first song on here is One of These Nights, which I actually the song as a whole I was kind of like iffy about, but the chorus part where they suddenly shift the key, I don't know, where they do something completely different, I was like, okay, like bring me this smooth kind of like a song, like I really like that part. So let me turn this up a little bit. Starts out with the strings. Sweet vocals. I feel like I'm actually hearing more of the song now. I feel like I didn't hear this piano before. I'm like watching the music video in my head and I'm remembering. This is Wendy, right? Nope, it's not. Just for a minute. Harmonies. I swear I did not hear this in the music video. This part, wait for it. Come on. When you heard that, don't tell me it got you shook up a little bit. It shook me up. The soft vocals, push them a little bit and then bring it back. These harmonies, I'm hearing everything suddenly. Heard this song, I was like, oh yeah, I love this chorus into the, you know, whatever comes after the chorus. I love that part. But now that I'm actually listening to it like fully, I'm kind of realizing the amazingness that is One of These Nights. I feel like I've just been like awakened to to like this great song. This is why you need to listen to the album, you guys. I feel like when you watch a music video, your mind is obviously doing two things at once. You're listening to the song, but you're also watching the video. So like it is so important to do or to listen to the albums, okay? You just saw me like jam, right? You saw me suddenly get into the song, even though I said 30 seconds before I was iffy about quite a few parts of the song. I'm trying to tell y'all something. Red Velvet Red Velvet has that effect on you, okay? They are surprising the shit out of you. You don't even know what you need to do. Okay. Next song is called Cold Hot Sweet Love. Wait. I said cold. That obviously is cool. That's okay. Get it together. That was a little okay. That kind of like clutched my heart for a second. Wait, did I say cool, hot, sweet summer or love? I don't remember. This suddenly became a hip hop song. It went from mad creeps to like hip hop. Fucking Red Velvet. is this song? Who the fuck does Red Velvet think they are? Okay, first of all, song started out mad creeps, okay, coming in with those creepy-ass vocals talking about some cool, hot, sweet love. Like, I was like, okay, what we doing, right? Then they start dropping a beat, making it definitely more hip-hop than I could have ever imagined. I said, okay, I'm listening. And then they gave me half of this chorus, which really reeled me in, and I was like, whoa, surprised again. And then something completely different. I honestly don't even know who wrote the song. Like, how did you get from all of this to that one half of the chorus where they're all singing together, very, like, known, loud, their presence is there, to go straight back into the quiet sort of, like, chilling vocals? Like, who are you? Oh my gosh. I was like, I'm really annoyed. It almost feels like three different songs that somehow work together. I don't know. Okay. Next song, Light Me Up. Okay. This had better give me a slow beat in like 10 seconds. Yes! The elements, they got me excited. Body. Come, baby boy. Let me calm down for a second. Hold on. Light me the fuck up. Okay, this song. Yes. This is what I want from Red Velvet. Oh my gosh. When I heard that beginning, that opening startup, I said, y'all about to drop this. I'm ready. Boom. Boom. Bam. Start right into the verse. Okay. Pure R&B. Okay. Pure R&B. We sound amazing. Also, light me up. So what did she say? She said, boy, come and light me up. I said, okay, yes. Set me on fire. Love this song. This is what I want from Red Velvet. More of this. Okay. Next song. First Time. Okay. I feel like this could be a song for a drama. Like during one of their moments when they break up or something. And then they do like different shots of them walking through the street looking desolate or something. We are deep in our R&B roots right now. I'm just like waiting for the chorus. That double bass in the background. No, not double, just that bass. Definitely a song meant for the dramas. I'm telling y'all. If they had just done this, they could have said, look, we got a song for y'all. Y'all gonna have some shots where they're looking sad. Play this. Bump this. Okay? That's the song they need for it, definitely. That's what this reminds me of. Okay, next song. Rose Scent Breeze. Ooh. a nice little piano intro.
Back into the strings we go.
Definitely more sad sounding than I would have guessed. Very, very mellow. Not R&B at all. Just mellow, calm, soft sort of sounding what we're getting for Rosette Breeze. Okay, now these next songs are all, I'm assuming, remixes. Okay, one of them is called, they're all One of These Nights, but one's the Da Capo version, Joe Millionaire version, and then piano version. And I'm wondering, are they just instruments? Or are they also singing along to it? Let's find out. This one, Da Capo version of One of These Nights. So they are singing. Just. Interesting. Just piano. I heard something, a little something. Interesting. The piano is like. Did anyone see that coming? Have you listened to this album? Did you tell me? Did you see that coming? That whoa, and that beat drop. That beat drop? Did anyone see that coming? Cause that surprised the living shit out of me. I was listening to the song. All I was getting was piano, and in the background I heard a little beat do like a rewind sort of sound. I said, okay, well, that's a little different. All right, switch up the elements. Okay, you know, whatever. But all we were getting was piano. And by the way, the piano was not on the same key as them. What I'm trying to say is that it was different, okay? It was not the same key. It matched them in a harmony, but it wasn't like the typical third harmony that you would do, and it was lower than them. So I was listening to this piano, I said, okay, whoever is doing this obviously is just like trying to like do something different. They just playing some keys, you know, whatever. But then all of a sudden, that woo and that beat drop came out of nowhere. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I was listening to this, and honestly, I said to myself, I'm gonna have to stop listening to these remixes because I don't think they're gonna be anything. But the Da Capo version might be something, so I'm definitely gonna check out the other ones. Okay, this one is One of These Nights, Joe Millionaire version. I'm already in it. I love the piano, I love the beat, and the sort of dropping noise in the background. This is the perfect body wave beat. A little like a trickling bell. OK. Okay. I just can't get over this chorus. I really love this chorus. That bass. Very interesting to hear how each producer, or really, I guess, I'm going to say producer, decides to kind of change up the song a little bit. This one had piano, obviously, but it also had a lot more beats throughout. A lot of different, like, sounds to hear throughout the song. Like, we heard one of those, I don't even know what you would call it, but, like, I'm trying to imitate it. It's like a bunch of, like, I almost want to say bells, but, like, you know, and then you run a string across it. Very nice throughout, giving it more of a kind of, reminds me of, like, 70s R&B. And just that one little musical element. And then they also had bass, instrument, the bass, playing throughout, giving us a little melody to follow, which was, I thought, very nice to put in. And I think it's very interesting the way that each producer has chosen to give a different beat after the chorus. This one is really nice. Okay, so this one's the piano version. I don't even know. Do you think we're gonna get, I don't think it's just gonna be your piano. I hit the laptop. Just the piano to follow along with. Just gives it a completely different feel without any beat whatsoever. Makes it a little bit more somber. I do like this piano version, but I will say I think the beat gives it a little bit more depth, if I'm being a little... I think the beat helps the song along when they have those moments, those critical change... Well, not even... Why did I say critical? When they have those changes in the keys in the chorus, I think the beat really helps carry it along. I do think the piano is nice, but I do think the beat kind of makes it a little bit better. If you know, that's just my opinion. So, okay... The Velvet, the second mini album. I definitely was feeling this. I was. Didn't have as many... I don't want to compare it to the first... Well, Okay. The first album, The Red, you know, their first full album. Amazing. I mean, amazing. There was only maybe like two songs in there I wasn't feeling. Now, on this one, I was feeling all of the songs, but I will say none of them moved me or got to me the way almost all of the songs did on The Red. Light Me Up, obviously, like, I'm here for it. And there were elements of the other songs that I really liked, but, like, The Red, with that one, literally almost every song was like, yes, you're in the playlist, you know? I think I'm only going to add maybe one or two, like, One of These Nights, the remix, the DiCapo remix, and then Light Me Up, I think is really the only one I want to put in the playlist. I mean, I'm not saying I didn't like it. I definitely did like this album, but it just didn't get to me the way that The Red did. But you know what, whatever. I still think of Red Velvet very highly when it comes to the album quality. Just really great stuff from them, like amazing stuff. So yes, girls, keep doing you, keep rocking it, keep killing the game. All right, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Twitter. Tell me what you guys think about this album. What's your favorite song? And yes, I will see you guys in my next reaction. Bye.